morning, everyone. Good morning, welcome. We'll wait a moment or two for others to join us. Good morning, Phil. Morning, Lindell. Thank you for joining us from a distance. Morning, Sally. The music I'm playing at the moment is called, oh, morning, Kathy. Haven't seen you for a while. Morning, Sigmund. Hello, Penny. Morning, Linda. Right, so the music I'm playing is called Ashana, Jewels of Silence. It's sound healing. That's what the cover, it's a CD, and that's what the cover looks like. I'll mention later why I've chosen to play sound healing this morning. Morning, Bev. Hello, Alan. Hope you're enjoying the sunshine. Well, I'm going to lower the music now so we can get started. So welcome, everybody. It's Thursday, the 24th of June today. And thank you for joining us for the Healing Minute. So if you'd like to make yourselves comfortable in whatever manner works for you this morning, and try focusing on your breathing, just taking deep breaths in and breathing out slowly at your own pace. And the more you take those gentle deep breaths in and those long slow deep breaths out, the more you'll find your body relaxing and your cares just drifting away. Suddenly all the petty incidents in life are meaningless when you're in that lovely state of stillness. So just inhale and exhale, aware of the breath, allowing any worries or concerns just to float up into the sky, joining those clouds, those beautiful white fluffy clouds, and allow them to just drift away. Now take your mind to the soles of your feet and see those roots, like the roots of a tree, going deeply into the ground, embedding themselves in a large crystal in the center of the earth, anchoring you on the planet. And just take this moment, these few moments of peace, tranquility, in your own space, and notice how still everything becomes. Just you, your space, and your breath. And as we commence our attunement, we give thanks that we are gathered here today and ask that our homes be filled with love, light, friendship, and healing energies. Surround us in protection as we open our hearts and expand our consciousness. Allow the flow of love and healing to come through us. As your crown chakra opens, allow a column of pure white light to flow down through your body. Feel the balance and harmony within your body as the earth energy rises up through the soles of your feet and your base chakra. Feel your connection to the universal source of pure unconditional love, balanced by the nurturing, protective love of Mother Earth. And I'm going to say a couple of the sanctuary and Harry Edwards prayers. So the sanctuary prayer. Heavenly Father, I surrender myself to the good influencing of your healing ministers in spirit, that through your divine healing power, the disharmonies within me might be overcome and the stresses of mind and body be eased and lessened day by day. Help me to adopt a more positive and helpful way of thought, bringing me into closer harmony with those around me and with the divine healing purpose. And for those who are sick or in the darkness of despair, who do not know of the help that can reach them from spirit, I pray that awareness will come to them soon, that they too might experience the upliftment of spirit that can lead us all through harmony towards true health. Amen. And the Harry Edwards prayer. May I be thankful for all the blessings I already have. Grant me relief from pain and sickness. Protect me from all ills and grant me good health in the days to come. Remove all causes of imperfection and bring your healing ministers close to me, that I may be conscious of their presence and so receive guidance and inspiration. Grant me courage and fortitude to overcome all adversity. Let me be conscious of your strength in all times of need. Grant me confidence to overcome my fears and not to anticipate harm. Teach me how to live rightly in your sight, to only do that which is right and true. I pray that good guidance and right influencing will inspire all your peoples to be as brothers, one to the other, and that peace shall endure for all time. Amen. And another one of our prayers, it's called Touched by Angels. We are touched by angels and walk where angels tread. They will guide us, walk beside us through the days ahead. In the hours of darkness, when our dreams have flown, they bring hope and gentle healing. We are not alone. In our times of doubting, still they understand. And forever touched by angels, we walk hand in hand. And as we plan to go into our minute silence, we now ask that all those whose names we hold in the Harry Edwards Distant Healing folder may receive healing for their highest good. We also request healing for their family, friends, and their loved ones. We may wish to add those in our own distant healing folders, those suffering worldwide, and all sentient beings. May they all be placed in the healing light and receive what they are allowed to receive for their highest good. And if you'd like to focus on the energy in your heart center, your heart chakra, to send out love and healing, I'll just ding this little gong, and in a minute's time I shall ding it again to bring us back. our thanks and blessings for all your help today and to all our friends in spirit. Well, time for our notices. This afternoon, 2 p.m., John Phillips is leading us in a guided meditation. As usual, it will be on Zoom and Facebook. It's the usual Zoom link. We use the same one all the time. So if you are free to join us this afternoon at 2 p.m., it will be lovely to see you. Tomorrow's Healing Minute will be taken by John. That's Friday. On Saturday, we'll have Stuart. I mean, Alan is taking a day off, probably his first day off in a year and a quarter. But hey, hard to get good stuff these days. So Alan's having a well-deserved day off, and Stuart will be with us. And on Sunday, we have Doreen as usual, in her usual spot. So, and thank you for sharing that beautiful healing energy today. It was really lovely. So today, I was going to have a little chat on the subject of protecting your energies. Now this, I'll just make sure the music is lowered. Just bear with me a moment. So this is a subject that some people feel they have no need for. The way they live their life gives them sufficient protection, and that's wonderful. It works for them, and that's brilliant. However, recently, I have come across quite a few incidents where, speaking to people, where protection was an issue. And so I realized, well, if quite a few people are having concerns along those lines and needed a little help and a few exercises, then it might be there might be other people who would be interested. So here we are. So, well, when I say protection, I'm talking about protecting your energy field. We sometimes refer to it as the aura. So it's basically, if you, for example, go to a social gathering and you find it's very crowded, or if you're in a supermarket and it's very crowded, or a train station or somewhere that's really busy with a lot of hustle and bustle, you might suddenly find yourself being drained, or you just feel your energy is being drained and you end up becoming dizzy and disorientated. And it can be because all this wonderful auric personal energy you have around you, all those crowds of people are draining you because you're open to their energy and they're draining you, and you may well be unaware of it. So if you haven't come across that before, it may be useful, as I said, just to have a few tools to help you should you feel you need them. So what is psychic protection? Well, psychic protection is something that basically strengthens your auric field, as I said, the energy centers. And with all the noise we have today and less space that we have around us, it can be useful to consciously take steps before we go out for the day, or if we know we're going to a particular event where we may well end up being drained. So it's not about creating barriers. It's about being aware of yourself and simply separating your energy from other people's energy so that you keep yours for you and they're welcome to keep theirs for them. You don't need the intruding on yours. So who needs psychic protection, you might ask? Well, basically anybody who opens their energy field. So once you're in a field of that nature, if you spend a lot of time in meditation, doing yoga, healing, working closely with other people, you might be living or working in a stressed environment. You might be affected by geopathic stress, for example. You may find you're accident prone, and you may find certain friends and work colleagues drain you more than others. So these are the kind of situations where you may feel it useful to protect yourself before you go into that environment for the day. So as I said, it's about setting strong energetic boundaries between your personal energy and other people's energy. So apart from our physical body, we have, apart from the actual physical here, we have other energetic bodies surrounding us, and this all forms part of our auric field. And these various bodies expand. One might be right next to us like a blueprint, and one is farther out, and others are farther out again to quite a distance. So if you've ever noticed, you're in a social event, for example, somebody may approach you and you instinctively cross your arms like this and protect your solar plexus, or find yourself going like this. You may be unconsciously sensing that they're either trying to take your energy or invade you somehow with their energy. And it's an instinctive protective device that people do this, or fold their arms like that, a defensive posture. So those are the sort of situations where you might step back and think, oh, I'll just quickly give myself a little protection here, and then I might feel less vulnerable. So there are lots of different ways of protecting yourself from in this manner. Some people, as I said, feel the need to never do it at all, which is absolutely fine. Some do it every morning, leaving the house. Well, that's entirely their choice. And some do it only when they know they're going to be in certain situations. But either way, it's useful to have a few quick methods. So if you don't even think of it, and suddenly you're in this situation where you find yourself, you know, like in your defensive posture, it's nice to have something quick that you can just have just like that. Sorry, I've never learned to snap my fingers. Something quick that you can have just like that. And that can be quite useful. So we'll just mention a few of those now in a moment. One method could be using essential oils. Now, I had a friend, and every time we went to her house, she used to run a meditation group years ago, and every time all of us turned up at her house, she happened to have a row of lovely essential oils. And instinctively, quite a few of us would just go over and basically sprinkle just about 3 drops or less on our hand and rub it together and just breathe in this the scent. And I would just do this with it around my body and even wipe it around my body like this, brush it here and there. And I noticed others did something similar. And it was, for us, it sort of got us in, it kept us feeling safe in the space. So with all the other energies coming in off the street, we weren't affected. We could sit in our own space from the beginning, if you like. So that was one simple method, if you use essential oils in any way. And another method, of course, is to listen to singing bowls and drums and sound healing music. And that's why this morning I've been playing a CD called Ashana, and it's by Ashana and Thomas Mark Barkey, called Jewels of Silence. I mean, there are many, many out there. I just happened to pick this one up this morning. So by playing those forms of sound healing, sometimes maybe while you're getting ready to go out, for example, you don't have to give it too much thought. You just have to tune into the music a bit, and that will give you a form of protection as well, should you wish it to. You can simply ask for help. You can, if you believe in guardian angels and spirit guides or archangels or power animals, you can call on any of those to help you. That takes one sentence or split second. So that's another one. A very popular one method of protection that's also quite quick is in visualizing yourself, or just knowing or thinking yourself as being like the yolk of an egg inside an egg. So if you can imagine an egg, and you've got the shell, which is the protective shell, and you've got the white bit, and then imagine you are standing where the yolk is. So except it's white light that you're standing in. So you're standing in the center of this oval shape of white light with this protective shell around it. So an egg is a very quick picture to bring up that that suggestion. And if you just see yourself standing in that and consciously asking to be in your protective bubble or egg, that's quite effective. You can also just place yourself in a bubble. It can be a bubble of light of any color you like. That might work for some people as well. So, what else? Oh, what also is very good for connection is walking barefoot on the earth, on the sand or the grass, and just standing barefoot on the sand and the on the sand or the grass, scrunching your toes into the sand, and on the grass, imagining those tree roots from the soles of your feet. That's a very good method as well, and it's very simple. Some people like to see themselves in a pyramid, and you can choose a particular color. Some like to see themselves standing in a column of light, just in that picture of a column of light, and you're standing in the middle of it. So as you can see, there are lots of different methods. And I'm just trying to see, have I got anything here that I thought I would mention? Oh yes, a hooded cloak of protection, Archangel Michael. People often do that. Often they visualize it as deep blue because that's his color. And you can see yourself being completely covered in this cloak with a hood covering you onto your feet, and some even ask for that golden sword of protection in front. So that's another method. So anyway, if you feel, as I said, that any of those appeal to you, that's just a selection of methods that are available out there. Some people like to wear crystals or wear other objects of jewelry that they feel would help them. If you feel you'd like it in your home, you could smudge it with sage or light incense or light candles. The thought is the basic point behind it all. Once you have the intention and the thought, well, whatever method you would choose is going to work for you. So while we're on that, I thought I'd finish off with a little protective method that you may find useful in the future. So if you'd just like to relax for a moment and take a deep breath in, and as you breathe in, see a line of white light drawn from the soles of your feet up the back of your body to your crown. And as you breathe out, imagine this line of white light being drawn down the front of your body to your feet, going underneath your feet. And as you breathe in again, you can see it, you can feel it, you can just know that this line of light is coming from under the soles of your feet, up the right side of your body, or either side of your body. And as you're breathing out, you can see it coming from your crown down the left or the opposite side of the body to the first one you chose. And we'll just do another round of that, and expanding it slightly this time. So once again, if as you breathe in, see a line of white light being drawn from the soles of your feet over up the front of your body to your crown. And as you breathe out, imagine it drawn down the back of, I should have started with the back of the body. So let's start again. So as you breathe in, see or just know or feel a line of white light drawn from the soles of your feet up the back of the body to the crown. And as you breathe out, see that white line of light going down the front of your body to under your feet. And now as you breathe in, see it coming from under your feet up the right side of your body to your crown. And as you breathe out, see it from your crown going down the left side of your body back to under your feet. If you wish, you can do more of those, and you can expand the bubble with each time. Or if you're happy with one or two, that's absolutely fine. It doesn't have to be a white light. It can be gold, blue, a color of your choice, whatever color you're comfortable with. So that's quite a simple exercise, and some people find that quite useful, as I said, to start their day. So once again, I will reiterate that not everybody feels the need to follow protection, but it's just due to some conversations with people I've had in recent times, it has occurred to me that a lot of people do feel they would like to have the tools to hand, and then they could use them whenever they feel like it. So I'll put our sound healing CD back on again. And thank you for listening to that this morning. Sometimes I'm trying to, so busy worrying that a lot of people don't quite get the right and the left, and I'm so busy worrying about who does and who doesn't, I end up getting it wrong myself. So there you go. So we'll just have a few moments of this lovely Jewels of Silence. It's meditation on the chakras. So it's crystal singing bowls. So once again, thank you very much for joining us for today's Healing Minute. And I'll see you next Thursday. And don't forget this afternoon, John Phillips meditation at 2 p.m. Thank you for joining us. Bye-bye now.